Here we discuss the other application of Pascal's law of transmission of pressure, hydraulic brake. Hydraulic brake usually used in motor vehicles, also works on the based on Pascal's law of transmission of pressure. See, this is the construction of hydraulic brakes. It contains a brake pedal. Brake pedal is attached to master cylinder. This master cylinder is filled with a liquid. Now this liquid is flowing through the cylinder like this. Now it is attached to brake shoes S1, S2. S1, S2 are the brake shoes which are connected with a spring S. And whenever to apply the brake pedal is pressed. Then pressure is exerted on the liquid in the master cylinder. The same pressure is transmitted in all directions like this. Now this presses the S1, S2 brake shoes against the brake lining. Whenever this S1, S2 pressed against the brake lining, then retardation is produced. Means the vehicle becomes slower and comes to rest. Whenever the S1, S2 expands, whenever S1, S2 are pushed away, the spring S will be elongated, and when the brake pedal is released, this spring S come back and brings S1, S2 back to the same positions. Like this, whenever the brake pedal is pushed, pressure exerted on the liquid in the master cylinder, the same pressure is transmitted in all directions. The which pressure is pushes the S1, S2, means S1, S2 is moved away from each other, pressed against the brake lining. When they pressed against the brake lining, the wheel of the vehicle becomes slower, and after traveling certain distance, it may come to the rest. Whenever S1, S2 pressed against the brake lining, the spring S is expanded, means elongated. When we release the brake pedal, S come back to the same positions and brings S1, S2 back to the same positions. In this way, hydraulic brakes works on the principle of Pascal's law of transmission of pressure.